Well, it's been a while since I filmed a makeup video, so let's do it. Today I'm going to show you guys what I did for my homecoming makeup. It was just a really like peachy, nudish look. I'm trying to be quiet because my sister's watching a movie and my dad's in the other room, and it's kind of weird, but you know, it's fine. So let's get started with the video. Started by taking my makeup off. Alright, now that I've got like a mostly cleanish base, I'm gonna start by prepping with my Badescu Rose Water Spray. And then I'm gonna moisturize with my First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Cream. We're done. Honestly, if I was actually gonna get ready for homecoming, I'd be using Benefit Professional to prime my face and skin or whatever. I'm not about to waste product, so I'm not gonna use it. If it was homecoming, I actually would. For foundation, I'm using the L'Oreal Pro Matte Infallible 24 Hour. Really good, really high coverage. It's a really good drugstore foundation, so. I lied, I'm actually gonna color correct first. So I'm gonna use my green concealer. Let's pop that everywhere I have acne. Blend that all in. Now I'm gonna go in with my foundation. I'm in the shade 105. I'm gonna bring it down my neck. Yeah, now that my face is caked with my foundation, I'm gonna go in with my two concealers. As always, it's the Maybelline Fit Me and the Collection Lasting Perfection. And then I'm gonna take my Naked Skin by Urban Decay concealer to go over any places where my acne is, which apparently I'm almost out of, so this is great. I'm in the tent, so this is getting in the way. Alright, so now that it's all blended out, we're gonna bake the face. I'm using the NYX HC Studio powder. Alright, while that's baking, I'm gonna start my eyebrows. I'm using the NYX Micro Brow Pencil. Great. I'm just gonna take Spoolie. Start blending this out. I'm going with my Benefit Gimme Brow. Great. Now I'm just gonna dust off all this powder and put it all over my face. For eyes, I'm just gonna prime with this white gel liner from NYX. I personally just like using this because like when you have a really light base, it makes the color look a lot brighter. And for the look I'm doing, it's very peachy, so I wanted that color payoff to translate onto my eye. First, I'm just gonna go in with white chocolate and just dust this all over the lid. This look is very, and I mean very similar to my peachy look, but it's a little more glam and a little darker, I think, so there you have it. For the rest of this look, I'm pretty much gonna be sticking to the Sweet Peach palette and then like maybe a couple random orange or pink shades and stuff, so just so you know. I'm gonna use a candy peach. This shade is my transition color. I'm really just gonna start building up that color. While I do want some brown tones in here, I really want the pink and orange to like show up really nicely. Obviously, I don't know what it is with this shade, but I love it. It's like the perfect balance between like an orange and a brown. I'm just gonna like use this to darken it up. Now that that's set in, I'm gonna keep darkening it up. I'm gonna be using a mixture of these two shades. It's gonna bring this into the outer V. Now, since I really want to translate this as like peach, I'm gonna go in with this. Oops. I'm gonna use this blush color. I think it's like the perfect shade, and I'm just gonna blend this in to make it a little more peachy and pink. Oops. Now that I'm kind of liking how the crease looks, I'm gonna go in with my good old L'Oreal Infallible, this 24-hour eyeshadow thing pot. These are very similar, in my opinion, to like the ColourPop ones, but in drugstore. So I'm just gonna take this on my brush. It's just like a little shadow brush. And I'm gonna place this on the lid. And this is like a really pretty like pink, like a rose gold sort of color. Okay. I really just want to emphasize like this middle part and then the inner corner of my eye. So I'm going in with a shade called Nectar. It's this very like, it's this very bright like peachy tone shade. I'm just gonna put this in the center, then on the inner corner, just blend it out with my finger. I'm just gonna take a little brush and going in with the salted caramel shade underneath. I'm gonna put this under my eye so it doesn't look too blank and bland and whatever. Now that everything kind of looks mediocrely like nice and blended out, kind of maybe, I don't know. I'm gonna line my waterline with the L'Oreal Infallible 24-hour black liner. I'm gonna go in with my Stila Stay All Day liner in dark brown. And I mean, it's basically black, so who really cares? Those are the lines. Now I'm only gonna apply a coat of the Tarte mascara because we're gonna put on falsies. For lashes, I just use the ones from Eyeler in the pink package. I can't find the box, but it's the pink one. I think they're called the Naturals or something. So yeah, they're very natural, very light and flirty. This side's looking a little wonky, but it's okay. We're not actually going to homecoming right now, so I'm just gonna leave it. We're gonna move on. I use my Hoola bronzer that's almost entirely out. Just to bronze it up a little bit so it don't look so pale. Pasty for pictures. Alright, and because my dress doesn't show really this part, I'm not gonna contour any of that or define the collarbone or whatever the heck. So we're gonna move on. For blush, I'm just gonna use the same one I used on my eyes, which is the Clinique one in the shade Cupid 108. It's gonna put this on the cheeks. The color is kind of similar to our eyes. Yeah, okay. For highlighter, using two as per usual. Using the Too Faced Rosy Glow. Then we're gonna put Becca's Opal on top of it because I'm that extra and I love me some highlight. I keep looking into the viewfinder, I'm sorry. You know what I forgot to do? I forgot to coat the glitter part with setting spray. I did that for homecoming, but I forgot to do it when I was actually applying my eyeshadow, so do that. You're gonna get a really cool, bright glitter color payoff if you use settings, if you coat your brush in setting spray. Yeah, please do that. For some reason, I can't find the shade I used, but for lipstick, I used the NYX like liquid suede and sandstorm, but I can't find it for some reason. So for now, I'm just gonna line my lips with the pencil and go in with a different color. Hopefully it's okay. Yeah, this is definitely not the color I used, but like, it doesn't look bad. So we're just gonna keep it, I guess. This is basically the completed look I did for homecoming. I was busy thinking about boys. 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 I was busy dreaming about boys. 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 Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed that. But yeah, I filmed some parts of homecoming. I vlogged it, of course. So here's those clips. Let's go to the vlog.
Happy homecoming.
Happy homecoming.
Hi.
Happy homecoming.
Hello.
We were so young when we thought that we knew how to love. Fought about anything, everything that did dysfunction. But we just gotta own that shit. Don't let it go like this. Maybe we can grow from this, yeah. We both know I go too far, like when I wrecked your car. Yeah, it's hard when you're young. Yeah, it's hard when you're young. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, oh, yeah. Yeah, it's hard when you're young.
Guys enjoyed that video. If you did, please give it a like, subscribe maybe, I don't know. I make mediocre videos and vlogs if you're into that kind of stuff. Maybe short films every once in a while. And yeah, I think that's about it. I really enjoyed my senior homecoming, and thank you everyone who spent it with me and made it special and very interesting. But yeah, I'll see you all in the next vlog or video whenever that goes up. Bye guys. Bye. Bye bye. Bye bye. Bye bye.